हेलो गाइस, हाउ आर यू? माय नेम इज भार्गव एंड आई एम बैक अगेन विद द अदर वीडियो. सो टुडे वी आर बेसिकली गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द थोरेसिक एओर्टा. सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा, इट गिव्स ऑफ द टू ब्रांचेस, थोरेसिक एंड द एब्डोमिनल. सो थोरेसिक विच इज लोकेटेड इन द पोस्टीरियर मीडियास्टिनल कैविटी फ्रॉम द फोर्थ थोरेसिक वर्टिब्रा टू द 12th थोरेसिक वर्टिब्रा विच देन in the diaphragm which continues at the abdominal aorta. So basically thoracic aorta is divided into three main parts: aberrant, parietal and the visceral. Aberrant is somewhat different, that it may be present or may be not present in some peoples. So aberrant is mainly present on the right side of the thoracic aorta near the right bronchial tree if it's present, and sometimes it also may form anastomosis with the right intercostals. And the next are our the parietal and the visceral. Parietal are the outer superficial branches and visceral are the deep branches. So starting from the parietal arteries, so parietal has three parts: intercostal, subcostal and the superior phrenic. So first of all, the intercostal are basically the nine pairs of arteries which are divided into two: the right intercostal arteries and the left intercostal arteries. They both form the anterior and the posterior ramus. The anterior ramus, which have the four branches main: collateral, intercostal, which forms the anastomosis with the intercostal of internal mammar, and the next is the muscular, which gives the blood supply to the intercostal and the pectoralis muscles, and it forms the anastomosis with the highest and lateral thoracic arteries of axillary. Next are the mammary artery, which are present in the 3rd, 4th and 5th intercostal spaces, and it provides blood to the mammary glands. During the lactation period, it increases in the size, somewhat increases in the size. Next are the lateral cutaneous. Lateral cutaneous also gives branches for the cutaneous tissues. Next are the subcostals. Subcostals gives off the posterior branches, and it there forms some anastomosis with the superior epigastric, the lower intercostals and the lumbar arteries. Next are the superior phrenic arteries, which runs on the posterior upper surface of the diaphragm and forms the anastomosis with the musculophrenic and the pericardiophrenic. So this was all about the parietal branches of the thoracic aorta. And next are the visceral branches of the thoracic aorta. The first is the pericardial. The name itself suggests that it supplies the blood to the pericardium, which is the outer sac of the heart, where it has the few smaller vessels. Next are the bronchial arteries, which are divided into the left bronchial artery and the right bronchial artery. Left bronchial artery and right. So going from the left, it's covered by the left pleura and the lung, and the right to the right pleura and the lung, which supplies the blood to the areolar tissues of the lungs and the bronchial lymph glands. It runs along the bronchus. The bronchus divides bronchi and shorter parts like that. The arteries along with divide with the bronchus. Next is the esophageal artery, which is the esophageal tube along with the esophageal tube, where it has major anastomosis, many anastomosis. Mainly it are 4 to 5 in the number. And esophageal forms the anastomosis with the inferior thyroid. Inferior thyroid means the esophageal branch of the inferior thyroid. It forms anastomosis. And also with the ascending branches from left inferior phrenic and the left gastric arteries. Next is the mediastinal. Mediastinal providing the blood to the mediastinal cavities, where it has numerous small vessels, lymph glands, and also to the loose areolar tissues along the side. So this was all about the visceral branches of the thoracic aorta. So hope you got the basic of the thoracic aorta and somewhat its deep branches. If you have some questions, you may write in the comments, and please subscribe to our video. Hope you like it. Thank you so much.